Everyone in this arena has a money stake in one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Convy.
Welcome to Tattletales. Thank you for tuning us in. Stick with us because we have three wonderful couples today. They're going to win money for people in our studio audience and play the game along with us. I've just gotten back from the road and I've been in a lot of nice places in Boston and Dayton, and I find that people play the game right along with us. So you do that, and in the meantime, here they are, winning money for the blue section today, Eva Gabor and her husband, Frank Jameson.
Hello, darling.
Hello.
You look awfully chic.
You look so pretty. What a pretty dress that is.
It's from our design, you know. I have a company.
Really?
Eva Gabor International.
Oh,
it's and
gorgeous.
We dressed the first lady.
Is that right, truly?
Yep.
Wow.
There was a whole page in the papers of the First Lady and Mrs. Rockefeller wearing this dress, the same dress to party.
But two different ones.
No, the same dresses, and they were marvelous about it. They said they loved it.
Really? They should have called each other before they left the house, shouldn't they? They're beautiful. Frank, how are you, sir?
I'm just fine.
Okay.
I'm just fine.
Ready to go for the blue section today?
Absolutely ready to go. That
all
was
right.
A lovely lunch you men put on for us.
Oh, all right.
Very nice.
Winning money today for the banana section, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Dennis James and his wife, Micki James. Hi, Bert. The banana section, as is their wont, are a little bananas today,
yes,
as you can see that.
Hey, Bert.
Yes, sir.
Did it ever dawn on you we have Jameson, James, and Jamie?
No, it didn't.
Just dawned on me.
Yeah, you're right.
Isn't that interesting?
James, Jamie, and Jameson. Yes, it sounds like an old law firm. James, Jameson, and Jamie. Jameson, and James.
Lawyer's the wrong word on this show, Bert.
Oh, sorry about that.
Okay.
Okay. Anyway, it's nice to have you winning money for the bananas. Sure. Winning money for the red section today, Mr. Jamie Farr and his wife, Joy.
Hi, Joy. You're tuned to the right program, Joy. I'm on your picture.
What was that, Jamie?
I said she's tuned to the right program. I'm on her picture.
Yes, she
right.
did. She
And the Reds will win.
Oh,
the
yeah?
Reds will win.
We'll
yeah!
see about that.
Tomorrow, match game.
Tomorrow, mash, we hope. Okay, if you're ready, fellas, here's the first question. It's worth $150. Men, you get home one night feeling very romantic. You find your wife with cold cream on her face and curlers in her hair. Would you give her time to pretty herself up? Oh, I'll say it again. You get home one night feeling very romantic. You find your wife with cold cream on her face and curlers in her hair.
What if she finds me with cold cream and curlers?
Well, then would she give you time to get pretty? Would you give her time to pretty yourself up? That's how she would find you. Think it over, fellas. We'll come back in a minute. We'll start with you, Ava. What would Frank do in a case like that?
Well, I would never be in cold cream and curlers.
Oh.
I would wear a wig. But he wouldn't give me any time.
No time at all.
No way.
That animal.
You know, those thoughts might fly away.
Yes. All those animals in the blue section. Yes. Okay, no, he would not give you time to pretty yourself up. Let's bring him on. Frank, what would you do? You come home feeling very romantic one night. You find Ava and curlers and cold cream on her face. Would you give her time to pretty herself up?
Well, in the first place, she wouldn't be in curlers because she has a hairdresser every day, and the answer is no, I wouldn't.
That's right. That's what she said.
She really doesn't wear cosmetics, and she just looks as young and beautiful all the time, so no way.
Yes, we understand that.
Ooh, I love
that.
You.
Oh, he's getting so many points and money for the blue section and everything. Thank you, Frank. Micki, how about Dennis? What's he going to say?
No, I don't think that he would bother with my preying myself up either. No,
no,
he would just get right to the point.
Yes. I think we get your meaning, and let's see what Dennis has to say. Steady, bananas. Okay. Dennis,
shut up.
You come home and you find Micki in hair curlers and cold cream, and you're very romantic. Would you give her time to pretty herself up?
Whoever writes the questions on the show write them all wrong.
Oh.
It would make no difference if I gave her time. She'd take the time. I'd have to wait.
Oh, no, that's
I'm
not...
I'm sorry.
What, that's not what the lady said.
I'm sorry.
Well, but I understand your point of view. Oh, sure, she probably would say, oh, no, wait.
We have friends who've been on this show, and they say that home is never quite the same again, and I believe it.
Because from now on, everything will go through your mind, every question you've had. Sorry about that, Dennis. Joy, what will Jamie say?
Well, I would... What's the question again? I was listening to them. I would say he would not give me time.
He would not?
No.
Oh. Would you give him time to get the curlers out of his hair? Is the question. Okay, he would say no. Let's bring him on. He will not. Jamie, you come home, and Joy has got curlers in her hair, and you've got curlers in yours. She's got cold cream on her face. Would you give her time to pretty herself up for you? Because you're very romantic.
I have been in that mood, yes, many times. But I would say, generally speaking, I would give her a chance.
That's not what Joy said, generally speaking. Not true? Is he lying again?
No, it's not. That's a joke. I mean, we Woody Allen movie, you know, and that movie that where in the restaurant, in the closet, and the...
Yes.
That is, but, you know, generally speaking, I enjoy negligees.
Yes.
And a lady, you know.
Yeah, I understand.
Right.
What did he just say? Do you have any idea?
I don't know.
You're wrong anyway, Jamie. I'm sorry. Right. Ava and Frank got the whole thing for the blue section, gang. And we'll come back in a moment with all the rest of the pods. Just the first question. Got a long way to go. Stick with us now. Here we go. Question number two coming up, and this is it. Fellas, if you're ready... Listen very carefully now. This is kind of a tricky question. Can you hear me, Dennis?
Oh, I hear you so well.
too well, eh? Here we go. Picture this domestic scene. You're barbecuing two steaks for a quiet dinner at home with your wife. You drop one of the steaks. No great tragedy, right? You dust it off. But here's a two-part question. First, do you tell your wife you dropped it? And second, who gets the one that dropped? Now, you must get both parts of the question correct to score. You're barbecuing two steaks for a quiet dinner at home with your wife. You drop one of the steaks. No great tragedy. You dust it off. But here's the question. First, do you tell your wife you dropped it? Second, who gets the steak that you dropped? You have to get both parts of the question right to score. Okay? Who gets it, and do you tell her that you dropped it? Think about it, fellas. We'll be back in a moment. Off they go. And we'll start with you, Micki. What would Dennis do in a case like this?
Surely we're going to get this one right. Oh. Because we're back on the honesty kick.
Ha.
If he dropped it, he'd say so.
Yes.
And he would also eat it.
And he would eat the one that he dropped.
He would insist upon.
Depending on what he dropped it in. Right.
Doesn't matter.
I'm sure he would eat.
All right. So you will say that he will tell you that he dropped it,
right.
And he will eat it.
Right.
Let's bring him on and find out. Now, don't say a word. Here we go. Hang on, everybody. All right, you're out there barbecuing, Dennis. Whoops, one of them falls off, and you pick it up, you dust it off a little bit, put it back on. Now, when you serve them, what do you do? Who gets the steak that was dropped, and will you tell Micki about it?
Are we ready?
Yes.
If you remember, there was a question the other day where about honesty. And if we lose this one, banana section, you can have my wife.
And as a fuel taker, too.
I would tell her I dropped the steak, and I would eat the
That's
dirty...
That's it! You got it. All right. Nice going. Nice
Thank
going,
you.
Bananas. You did that
Thank
beautifully,
you.
And you did too, Dennis. Thank you.
You.
Has it ever happened to you, Dennis?
No.
No.
I cook the steak.
That's right. She cooks the steak.
Because she cooks them.
She mixes the cocktail.
Okay, Joy.
Listen, I'll tell you this, though. People criticize me for helping, you know, vacuuming the rug and everything. They criticize it, but I do it because, after all, she helps me with the dishes.
Sure.
You know.
I was just going to ask, if you drop the vacuum, do you eat that too or no?
I dropped it on my toe once and broke a toe. Let's go on.
Okay, Joy, how about Jamie? What's he going
to
say?
Well, Jamie is very good to me, and I always come first. So he would tell me he dropped it, and he would eat the steak himself.
He would tell you, and he would eat it.
Right.
Let's bring Jamie on and see what he says. Jamie, there you are, barbecuing steaks for a nice, quiet dinner between you and Joy. You drop one of them. Now, the question is, two parts. Are you going to tell Joy that you dropped it? And who is going to eat it?
There's so many ways I can answer this, and if it's the wrong way, I'll find it.
Yes.
I would say that if I dropped the steak, that I would not tell Joy about it, and that I would take the steak.
That's not what you said.
Yeah. I told you. If I find the wrong way, I knew.
No, you
got it. Why? What makes you think?
She thought that you would tell her you dropped it and eat it. You just said you wouldn't tell her, but
why?
You ate it. Well, if you weren't going to eat it, why wouldn't you tell her?
That's true, but I mean, if I was going to give it to her, then I would tell her about it.
I want to change husbands, partners right now.
I understand.
He's really, this is terrible.
I'm sorry, darling, I dropped this in the mud, but it's for
you. It's for you.
Yeah. that's the old joke. Isn't that funny? Yours dropped them on the ground. Ava.
That was yours.
How about Frank? What will he do in this case?
Well, Frank is such a gentleman, and he barbecues so well, he would tell me, and he would insist on eating it.
Right. Would you let him eat that steak?
Oh, yes, I would.
Okay. Let's bring him on. Frank, you're barbecuing steaks for you and Ava to eat alone, just the two of you. You drop one of them. What are you going to do? You're going to tell her that you dropped it or not tell her? And who gets to eat that steak?
I've been raised in corporate life. We'd write one off and give it to the dogs, and we'd share the other one. She'd take one-third, and I'd take two-thirds. But that isn't the answer to your question, so I guess I would tell her that I had dropped it, and then I would probably she would insist I have the good steak and she'd have none. So I'd have the good steak, and I would tell her I dropped it.
No, that's not what she said. She said you would tell her you dropped it, but she'd also say that you would eat it. You see?
She wouldn't let me.
She wouldn't let you?
I would.
Oh, yes, she would. Sorry about that. Micki and Dennis got the whole thing for the banana section. Halftime, gang. We'll trade places. We'll bring the fellas out front. Second half coming up. Hang on. It's pandemonium. Hello there. We've changed places after halftime. Have I got a question for you? Ladies, are you ready? This is it. We have
a minute, though, for a confession with Father Frank here.
A confession with Father Frank.
Here we go. You can kiss his ring. Ava, you and Micki are tied. You have $150. Enjoy. You and Jamie are trying to get
something's
it together.
Something's wrong with our marriage. No. Something's wrong with this game
no,
show.
No, no, no. It's going to be fine. Don't you worry. Ladies, here comes. Ladies, what do you think is your husband's most attractive physical feature?
Here you go again. Oh, my God.
What do you think is your husband's most attractive physical feature? Think it over, ladies, and we'll be back in a moment for your answer. Off they go, seemingly perplexed. Jamie, we'll start with you.
Naturally, she's going to say what is 98% of my body, my profile. That's what she's going to say
your
is
profile.
The most attractive...
I never noticed your lips before.
Yeah.
I think you mean your proboscis.
Yes, my proboscis. Right, the nose. Right. Well, that's the profile, isn't it? That's what I was talking about.
You're getting a shot of your nose there.
What am I asking them? Why? Yeah.
I would
say that
most attractive
that is,
physical feature.
Yeah, I get a lot of fan letters, and they say that they think I have a very sexy nose. Some of them are from girls.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I know a hanky factory. You can make a big...
No, I will retract that. I will say my eyes.
Your eyes?
Yeah. I will say my eyes that Joy thinks that I have the most attractive eyes.
She does.
Yeah.
That's what she likes about you. Okay, let's bring her on and see what she says. Mm. Joy, what do you think is Jamie's most attractive physical feature?
All right. I think he has beautiful eyes.
That's it! Yeah! That was beautifully done, Jamie. You did that beautifully. Frank, how about Ava? What will she say about you?
I now know why some of these people in Washington stand on the Fifth.
Yes.
And, you know, some congressmen say, why do you walk down both sides of the street? And they say, that's all there are.
Yeah.
You know.
Middle of them.
I would guess that if you can't say physique, you'd say height. Ava likes my height.
She likes your height.
She's 5'2", and I'm 6'6".
Right. Okay. I don't blame her. And I'm not going to argue with you about it either. She'll say your height. Let's bring her on and see if she agrees. Ava, what do you think is Frank's most attractive physical feature?
I stand on my constitutional rights.
That's what he said.
I he has the most incredible, beautiful, long legs.
No, that's close, though, but that's not what he said.
How much closer can I get?
Well, he said his height, that he was, that you loved his, that you really admired his physical height.
But
he's
that's
so
long legs.
Yeah, but he's got more than legs. There's something else on top of it.
Most of him is legs.
Most of it's legs.
Yep.
Well, you got, almost got most of an answer. I'm sorry about that. Micki, what will Dennis say to this? I mean, Dennis, what will Micki say to this?
I don't have one attractive feature.
Oh, I think he's got a lot of attractive features,
don't
you?
I'm not trying to be unduly modest. I'm trying to remember back at different times whether she might say, well, your nose is all right, but I used to have a bump on my nose. Eyes, I think eyes, right? My bedroom eyes or my movie lips? Eyes, okay. You did it, eyes.
Eyes it is, the eyes have it. Let's bring on Micki. Micki, what do you think is Dennis's most attractive physical feature?
His most distinctive fixture. What'd you say?
Fixture.
Fixture.
Feature. His most attractive
right,
physical feature.
No, I'm forgetting his voice. That's not a feature, but everybody knows his voice. I'm going to say he has a very warm, wonderful smile.
No, that's not what he said.
He
said his eyes. He thought you'd think that his eyes were darling.
I love his big brown eyes.
When you have a nose like he's got to win the whole thing. If he didn't have eyes, where would he be? See, poor Frank and I, we were lost on that one, weren't we, Frank?
No, but he didn't win with his nose. He won with his eyes.
I know.
Of course, about hitting below the belt.
You talk about
like
winning
that,
by
I mean.
A nose. Jamie right. and Joy got the whole thing for the red section game. We have a three-way tie game. We'll come back in a moment with a $300 question and break that tie. Come on back. This one will decide it. $300 on this one. Here we go, ladies, it's for you. We know you're not nags, but on those rare occasions when you do nag your husband, is it more often about things you want him to do or about things you don't want him to do? Okay? We know you're not nags, it says, ladies, but on those rare occasions when you do nag your husband, is it more often about things you want him to do or about things you don't want him to do? Think it over. We'll see in a minute. This will decide it. Off we go. Frank, we're going to start with you. Oh, they all think they got this one in the bag, gang. Tell us about it, Frank.
She doesn't like me to drive fast. She thinks I'm worse than Barney Oldfield. And there's several other things that she hates to see me do. And she would say those things in a very friendly way.
Right. So if you have to make a choice, it'll be about things that she doesn't.
Exactly.
About things you don't want him to do.
Now, can I just say one or two? Is that what I say when you ask me the question? Because we've already answered it.
You've answered it now.
Yes.
Yeah.
I didn't realize we were on the air. I thought this was still intermission. I'm sorry.
Oh, no.
The answer is yes. That's right. It's things that she does not want me to do.
Yeah, right.
Forgive me.
Okay, that's fine. We snuck up on you there,
yeah,
didn't we?
Yeah, yesterday was a better day.
Okay, she nags you more about things that she doesn't want you to do. Let's bring her on. Eva. When you do nag Frank, is it more often about things you want him to do or about things you don't want him to do?
It's one thing I don't want him to do.
That's the answer. What is that one thing I wonder?
I tell you, I don't want him to smoke.
Oh, that's one of the other things, huh? Okay.
What did he say I was nagging about?
His driving, as a matter of fact.
Yes,
one
that's
thing.
Number two.
Should we continue or should we just move right along?
One.
No, that's enough. You have a share of the pot, too. Thank you. All right, Dennis, how about Micki? What was he saying?
I think that we got it again, Yellow. We really got it again. She nags me about things that she wants me to do, because I told you earlier I'm a golf nut. I have any time off. I want to play golf. And on weekends, she says, why don't you fix that screen door? Do. She doesn't care about telling me not to do things.
Right, things she wants you to do.
She things she wants me to do.
Okay, let's bring her on. Here she comes. Oh, Swanee. Micki.
Yes.
When you do nag Dennis, is it about things you want him to do or about things you don't want him to do?
A wild stab in the dark, and I'm going to say it would be if I nagged about what I would want him to do.
That's it.
Right?
That wild stab was right.
If she went the other way, I swear, Bert, I'd go home.
Well, no, you don't have to.
I don't have to.
You're absolutely right. We still have a tie. So here it comes. Jamie, you're going to keep it that way?
It sounds to me like it's the same question, but I'll answer it. No, these aren't mine. What am I doing?
They're not mine.
Father Frank? I would say that they were things that she would not want me to do.
Yeah.
Like, that's what I would say.
Any examples?
No, I ain't going to say it. Oh, okay. She wants to say it. It's up to her.
Okay. Things she does not want you to do. Okay, let's bring her on. Joey, when you do nag Jamie on those rare occasions, is it more often about things you want him to do or about things you don't want him to do?
I want him to do.
Oh, no! Guess what? Micki and Dennis, Ava and Frank got it. They split it in half. Time is up. We have a tie. The Bananas and the Blue Section tie it. And we'll come back in a moment and let you know just exactly how much they tied for. See you in a minute. A tie. The yellow section and the blue section with Ava and Frank, Micki and Dennis, $300. We had a grand. They will divide $1,600 between them. That's all we have time for. Thanks for tuning in. Bert Gonvey saying, so long, everybody. See you next time on Tattletales.
This is Gene Woods speaking for Tattletales. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program has been edited for broadcast.